25, it felt like I just started life, even though I was living with my parents. When I survived all the way to 25, it was because I had an awesome dad. And back then I was still in medical school, learning why we pass inflatus, or why do babies drool. And I wanted to choose a specialty that was absolutely cool, because I happen to have an awesome dad, he's a totally awesome dad.
2, 3, 4.
At 45, I was still very full of drive. The kids were growing up way too quickly. When I survived all the way to 45, I wondered if I could be an awesome dad. I thought about my dad back then a lot, and how he could sleep so peacefully, whether in his bed or not, and that he could build and fix things in ways that I could not. And I knew that he was still an awesome dad. Awesome dad, he's a totally awesome dad. Awesome dad.
1, 2, 3, 4.
At 55, I'm surprised to be alive, but wonder why I don't have any grandkids. Since I survived all the way to 55, I'm glad to still be with an awesome dad. And I wonder if I will ever throw some horseshoes and become more like him and hardly ever lose. But he's still above me on the evolutionary ladder, 'cause he's 85 and still controls his bladder. Controls his bladder. He can still control his bladder. Control his bladder. 85, we're glad our dad is still alive. Wonder if he'll ever stop playing hand and foot. Yes, he survived all the way to 85, and there's no question he's an awesome dad. And let's all give 3 cheers and 1 big shout to tell him that we love him and will never boot him out, and that his life has taught us what family's all about. And he will always be our awesome dad.